In this video, we will learn how to get started using system accounts in SAM.gov. System accounts are for information systems that need to connect to SAM.gov for large data transactions on a repeated basis. Application programming interfaces, or APIs, are used to link system accounts with data from SAM.gov. Any SAM.gov user can request access to a system account. Before submitting a system account request, you need to first determine what data you have a business need to access and what kind of system transactions you want to complete. If you are just pulling data or using GET calls, you will only need read permissions. Non-federal users can have only public read permissions. If you are writing, sending, or using post or put calls, then you need write permissions. Only federal accounts are allowed to write data, and only federal accounts can access for official use only, or FUO, data or sensitive data permissions. SAM.gov API documentation is available at open.gsa.gov/API. You can review available data there and decide what you need to access. No specific roles or permissions are needed to get a non-federal system account. You only need a basic user profile on SAM.gov. If you are a federal user and need write permissions for a system account, you need to request a system account manager or system account administrator role from your agency's current system account administrator. Sign in to your SAM.gov account and from your workspace, select the System Accounts widget. Next, select the New Account button to start the new system account request process. Enter the required details and select Next. In the next section, you can enter the specific information for an entity or federal organization. If your SAM.gov account is already associated with a federal agency or a registered entity, then that organization's data will be pre-populated in this field. Associating your system account with a department or entity connects it to that organization. It allows multiple users within an organization to share a single system account. For non-federal users, this section will be labeled Entity Information. Non-federal users must have a current public entity registration in SAM.gov to associate it with a system account. If you do not wish to connect the system account with an entity, then you can leave this blank. Next, enter the email address of another non-federal user who has a SAM.gov account. This user will be a joint account holder for the system account and will have permission to manage it. You cannot enter your own email address into this field. This joint account holder must approve the system account request before GSA reviews the request. You will see an error message in red next to the field if you do not enter a valid user who meets the requirements. At this step, the section is labeled Organization Information for Federal Users, and you will see your organization's hierarchy. If your role is specific to a sub-tier or an office, you will only be able to associate your system account at that level. A system account administrator at a higher level will be able to manage your account and grant higher access if needed. In the next section, select the data access permissions you need to connect with the domain that you want. Remember, non-federal users can only have public read permissions in SAM.gov domains. Selecting the Terms of Use button will open a window that displays the full text of the Terms of Use. Later, you must acknowledge and agree to these terms when you submit your system account request. Select Next to continue. In the Security Information section, enter the system's external IP address. You can identify your public or external IP address by running a search on an internet browser asking, "What's my IP?" and the IP address is listed in the search results. You may enter multiple IP addresses one at a time or enter a CIDR mask to allow for a range of IP addresses. Enter the additional required information in the Security Official field. Enter your agency's or entity's system security officer or other security representative. This security point of contact is not required to have a SAM.gov account. Select Next to continue. In the Authorization section, add supporting documentation such as an MOU or other official documentation that validates your system meets federal data access standards. This documentation is required for federal system accounts and includes your system's authority to operate, or ATO. Confirm the information you provided is correct and select Review. You may select Edit in any section to change information before you submit the request. When you're finished, navigate back to the review page. Select Submit at the top of the page. After you select Submit, the system will prompt you to review and accept the terms of use. The system will then send you a one-time password to the email address associated with your SAM.gov account. Enter it to agree to the terms and select Submit. The system will navigate you back to your system account's workspace, and you will see your request is shown in the pending review status. The joint system account user listed on the request will be notified of the pending system account request. That user must sign into their SAM.gov account to review and approve or reject the request. If approved, the request will move to the pending permissions approval status for review by GSA security personnel. All status changes are recorded in the history of the system account request. Once your system account is active or published, you will need to get your system account API key. An API key gives you access to our APIs to get or pull or push detailed information from the system using various parameters. There are two types of API keys: personal and system account. In this video demonstration, we will show you how to get your system account API key. Please see our video titled Data Extracts and APIs to learn about the personal API key. Sign in to your SAM.gov account and navigate to the workspace. Select the System Accounts widget to go to your System Account Details page. Select the title of the system account you want and scroll to the System Account Password section. Now that your system account is active, you will need to set a password. Once the password is set, a success message will appear, and options to reset the password are available so you can change it in the future. Below the password section, you'll now have a Generate API Key button. Select it and enter your system account password. Once validated, your API key is generated and displayed on the screen. Please note that API keys expire every 90 days. You will receive email notifications beginning 15 days before the expiration of the API key. A backup API key is generated for you on the 75th day. Both the newly generated and previously available API keys will work during this 15-day window before the older key expires. Both keys are available on the System Accounts Detail page. You must also reset your system account password every 90 days in order to keep it active. You will receive notifications before the password expiration that will provide you a link to the system account details page. Now you are ready to start using your system account. Again, you can find all the documentation for SAM.gov APIs at open.gsa.gov/API. Thank you for watching this video about system accounts. Remember, you can search the Federal Service Desk knowledge base for additional videos and frequently asked questions, or get help with technical issues at fsd.gov. To provide GSA feedback about features, functionalities, or the user experience in SAM.gov, click the Feedback button located at the bottom of each page.